I am running a few minutes late to a therapist session that I always go to on Thursday mornings. So I am kind of in a rush. I had a phone call this morning about a surgery. I know I mentioned it last video and wanted to talk more about it today at some point. Maybe when I'm not in such a rush. Good morning, everybody. It is April 11th. I had to get up kind of early today. It is now 10:30 in the morning. Today has been a whirlwind already. Did that person just go? Oh, man. Just got out of my...
Ooh, there's a bug.
Just got out of my therapy appointment, so it's just about 11:44. Pretty tired. I think I'm just gonna go home and maybe take a nap, I don't know. I also wanna deal with this thing on my nose. I realized that it might be what's called a cystic acne or something like that, where it's like a pimple that doesn't have the head, which is like the part that you would pop, right? So what I'm supposed to do is put like a hot compress on it. So I'm gonna do that when I get home. I also wanna go work out again. Probably eat first. Why does it always feel like there's so much to do? I don't even have a job and it feels like I'm busy all the time. Also still need to do my taxes. I think I'm just gonna file for extension at this point. I feel like 4 days might not be enough. After eating and doing the hot compress, I'm just so tired. So I think I'm gonna take a nap and then probably work out. I can't stop looking at this thing on my nose. Is it? Oh my God, that's so gross. Can you guess? That is so gross. I want it to go away. Anyways, I'm gonna take a nap. I'm tired. Peace. I'm gonna win the staring contest. Oh, you blinked. I win.
Why are you like this? You're just looking at me, menacingly. Nyanko! Nyanko!
Okay. So I was gonna vlog the Q&A videos, but turns out my vlog camera is running out of batteries, so while it's charging, I decided that I'm just gonna do my Q&A here in my stream setup. And yeah, let's get started. Question is, when did I start asking for questions with the Q&A? Let's start answering some questions, because now I finally see them. Here we go. First question by Duke Serg. I'm 21, been working construction since high school, tried college but didn't know what I was going to do, so dropped out. Now I'm going back to college in the fall so I can get some skills in video editing and production. I'm currently unemployed, looking for jobs and internships here in LA. Do you have any advice for someone who has no experience in the production and entertainment business? Also, how do I make my break in the field of entertainment with no skill but the desire to learn? So, talking about the entertainment field and like video games and video editing and this all sorts of stuff, I think the first thing that I would look at is, unfortunately, there's no easy answer. I wish the entertainment business was kind of structured the way certain other things are. There's no like certification degree that you can get. The job path, it tends to be much more loose and not linear. So my best advice to anybody who's trying to get into this space is to sort of create your own opportunities. And I know that sounds shitty, but like the way I personally got started was I found out esports organizations were taking in, you know, production people back in the day. I know for a fact that esports organizations these days will take in interns and production people because there's no shortage of them. I would go out and reach out to any place possible. I think one of the first mistakes that people can make is that they kind of have like the goal of where they want to work at in the future, and so they make that their first goal. But honestly, the first things to sort of consider is, where can you find experience and where can you get paid in those experiences? The pay is not going to be great at first either, because the entertainment industry is very top side heavy, and so generally people who are working their way in don't get paid very much, or if at all. I mean, there's like the meme with Dignitas paying people in mouse pads and keyboards and such like that. You kind of have to weigh for yourself how much are you willing to sort of suffer in terms of pay to get the experience that you need. Otherwise, like I said, you can kind of create your own opportunities, make your own things. You know, if you're someone who's trying to get into filmmaking and or screenwriting, you just gotta make stuff and see how it goes. I think the first mistake to there is to sort of wait for an opportunity to present itself. I think, you know, anytime you're in a creative field, you nowadays you have the option of being discovered through the stuff that you're doing. So I don't know if that's helpful, but that's sort of my answer to that question. Question from Ashley. How did you start your job at Riot and why did you leave? So I've already addressed why I left Riot Games. And that's in a different video that you can find. But how did I start my job at Riot? That's a pretty interesting one because it was pretty nonlinear. I didn't really get into Riot through a traditional path. So I was working at Team Curse at the time before they became Team Liquid. And I had been applying to different places as an editor because I had some baseline editing skills. And so I was like, you know, I like Riot. So like, let's do a feeler. So it turns out what happened is they looked at my resume and they looked up my video reel, and part of it had some of the sketches and videos that I had partaken in. And from that, they decided that maybe it was a good place for them to try me out as a host. And so my actual first entry into Riot Games was being their host for All Chat. And so the way that worked was I got an email. I still remember this day. I got an email from a writer named Matt. And he was like, yeah, there's a show that we're trying to make and we were curious if you want to audition for it. And I thought this was a total hoax because I didn't really expect to get anything back from Riot. I had heard about their application process and how nebulous and kind of disheartening it can be. And so anyways, I get this email and I actually thought it was just like a prank. Someone was pulling on me and I was like, is this actually legit? And turns out it was, and I auditioned, and the audition day was crazy. There were some people that I like had heard of. This is actually the most brutal thing ever, is that everybody who was auditioning had their names listed down on this sheet of paper. So there was a call sheet with everybody. You could like Google everybody and see who everyone was except me, because I was a nobody at that point. And so I was really, really scared going in, but somehow I ended up landing the role. And I still remember some of the people I had met back then. Cody POV was on that. There were some like traditional actors, like Osric Chow was someone who auditioned, and I was like, oh my god, this guy is like a real actor. And he's auditioning. Obviously Melanie Mack was there. There was a couple other writers who were also looking for the hosting gig as well. So yeah, it was a very nerve-wracking experience, but very valuable. This is from Potato. What is your typical workout on an average day? So when I work out, I generally have split days of whether I do chest and tricep and shoulders. That's like one day of workouts, and then the other day is back and biceps, some leg work as well. I should be doing more leg work, but turns out my legs are already really chonky and I don't really want to get them any chonkier, so I just tend to do more leg based cardio workout as well, you know, like running and stuff like that. All right, from some dweeb, who is your Smash main? I will judge you very strongly on your answer, by the way. So for Melee, I've been playing Fox for a long time, and so he is my Melee main. In Smash Ultimate, I play Wolf, so you can judge me however you wish. I play both very top tier characters, but you know what? They're fun. So I want to say this right now. If you're a fighting game player, just pick a top tier. There's this video I love to link to people. Just pick a top tier. Just do it. Just win. Feel good about it. Feel good about being good at the game, even if you're getting carried by your character. Question from Han Soars. What are some of your favorite food spots in LA/K-Town? I absolutely love this one Seolleongtang place called Hanbat. They're amazing. amazing. They take cash only. It's like the small hole in the wall place. I love it. Korean barbecue wise, I've already talked about Kangho-dong. That's my personal favorite place, but it's a little pricier, but I think it's personally worth it. Other places I really like are Sawtell has really, really good ramen places and just good food overall. So those tend to be my favorite food spots in LA/K-Town. Also by Hansors, how has anime shaped your life? In what ways has anime been a benefit for you and how so? It's funny, growing up, anime was sort of my escape from the world. I'm generally kind of an escapist. When like there's a big stressor in my life, I tend to try to run away from it. And so I got really into video games and books and anime as a result. In the way it's shaped my life, it's sort of given me a different perspective. I've kind of been able to live vicariously through some of these characters and some of the things that they deal with. And really, you know, it's funny, it's gonna sound really cheesy, but sort of the idea of working really hard and trying to reach a goal, like Shonen has really taught me that you can just work really, really hard and it'll give you a good shot at making your goals happen. And so yeah, I don't know. It's kind of taught me that sort of work ethic that I live with today. So that's kind of how it's directly impacted my life. Will T, who is the best waifu in Smash Ultimate? Hint, any answer besides Palutena is objectively wrong. No, Palutena. God, I hate the way she plays in that game. I don't really like the keep away game. I like Lucina because, again, she's top tier, not only in the game, but in looks. Oh my god, that pink palette on Smash Ultimate is so good on her. She kind of looks like Lightning from Final Fantasy 13. So yeah, I really like it. Zell, what is your favorite color? That's a hard one. I've typically always liked the color blue, but these days I really like the color red. Also black. Black is forever. I just, at least that's what my wardrobe says. How was growing up as an anime watcher and gamer? So I don't know, for me, gaming was always a passionate hobby of mine. And luckily, I think most of my friends were always into video games. As far as anime is concerned, it was funny because anime was a very personal experience for me. A lot of the other people that were into anime, I was kind of like, you guys are a little much. For example, in high school, I remember there was an anime watching club and I just could not relate to those people whatsoever. And so anime became something that I kind of watched with my closest friends and with myself. You know, as far as gaming, the only sort of experience I remember really that sort of set itself apart was in college, actually, when for the first time I became friends with people who really didn't like video games. And that was kind of a surprise to me because I had never dealt with that before. You know, sort of the idea of being bullied for watching anime and gaming had never really happened to me. But then suddenly in college, it kind of became a thing where my friends made fun of me for, you know, staying in and wanting to play, you know, this MMO rather than going out partying. And so I ended up having a falling out with those set of friends, and then finding new friends who were into League of Legends. And that's actually how I got into the game. How painful is it to get your orbital pierced? So this is actually fake. So I'm a fake person. So it's not real. My mom got me this ear cuff, and so I've been wearing it since. Maybe one day I get it actually pierced. I don't know. Kid Trinity asks, do you have a Dakimakura? If so, can you show us for research? Hold on. So I still need to get the actual pillow, but one of my subs actually gifted me a cover for this character Shinobu, which I love from Monogatari. It's not super lewd, but actually it's kind of lewd. I don't know. If you had to pick a single anime and manga to read for the rest of your life, what series would you pick? One Piece, easy, because it'll never end and it's actually really good. So boom, easy question. Volley the Gamer asks, what kind of camera do you use to vlog? So I have a Canon G7X, and this guy was gifted to me actually by my stream community back in the day. Those are most of the questions that people had asked me in my YouTube comments. So yeah, I don't know, maybe this becomes like a weekly thing, like weekly Q&A. I don't know, maybe I use some of my other social media for more questions, stuff like that. But yeah, thanks for asking those questions, guys, and I'll probably do more of that in the future. Hopefully my camera battery is charged so that I can vlog some other stuff in the day. Camera is nice and charged now. I think I'm gonna go stream more Sekiro and die a bunch of that game.
And then I feel like I, oh yeah, and then I have a meeting with my mods because they're helping us. It's not just mods. We have like an event committee for our Discord because they are organizing events for our Discord. By the way, if you want to join the Discord, it's in the description below. That's where I hang out and a lot of the community hangs out. But yeah, I'm going to go start the stream now and yeah.
What happens now? Where's he going? Oh, what the fuck? No, what the fuck is, no, what the fuck? No, not like this. Mommy, what the fuck? What is wrong with you, game? What the fuck is wrong with you, game designers?
Well, I just got done streaming and one of the bosses I faced in Sekiro just tilted me off the face of the universe. I'm now very hungry, I'm sweaty because it's hot in my room, not because of the video game, but I'm also a sweaty gamer. I don't remember what I said, but now I have a headache as well. Did I say that already? I don't know, but I gotta make food and maybe this is a chance to make some new food, although I'm kind of feeling just a quesadilla. I'll make good food starting tomorrow. I felt a little guilty just doing a cheese quesadilla because I just got groceries, so I'm gonna try cooking cheese chicken quesadillas to level up. Alright, I don't know how many chicken pieces I need, but one, two, boop, chicken. Maybe I should try some seasoning like this, chili lime. That sounds pretty good, right? Some pepper, some not cinnamon, I don't want cinnamon. Where's salt? Garlic salt? Let's do garlic salt, that sounds good. Some of this stuff too. All right, we're cooking. Like, I don't know, I just like mushed it all in there. Maybe turn it around a little bit. Some of the oil, I don't know. Maybe it's fine. I have no idea. Okay. Let's hope that works out. All right, I think the chicken's coming along nicely. Huh, look at that. Not bad. I'm cutting up the chicken right now. I realized I should have cut the chicken before I start cooking it because now it's like hard to cut it because I can't really. Ooh, I should try one. Ooh. Dude, this is solid. Good job, Josh. Good job. And put it into my quesadilla. Oh man, I have way too much chicken, huh? Ooh, 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 ooh. Cha, okay. It's gonna be one chonky quesadilla.
So chic.
Slap this shit on there, boom. It's like a pie, not a quesadilla anymore. The final product, ladies and gentlemen. It's oh shit, I burnt that. Fuck, at least it's not super burnt. Oh man, I was cleaning the dishes, figures, god damn it. It doesn't look that burnt. Yeah, a little crisp is fine, right? Just a little crisp. Whatever, tastes good, doesn't matter. I realized too that I forgot to cut the quesadilla, so I'm just taking bites out of it. It's pretty good. It's let me see if I can do this one hand. Oh no, I dropped a piece of chicken. Okay. Let me try to bring this to my mouth with the camera in hand. It's good. It's actually pretty good.
I know that doesn't look very appetizing, but it's actually pretty good. And you can trust me, I swear to God, it's actually not bad.
Got done eating and watched a couple more episodes of Bungo Stray Dogs. I guess to wrap up today's vlog, I wanted to talk about the surgery that I mentioned earlier on. I have problems with my eyes, like a lot of problems. And part of it is that I get allergic reactions in my eyelids, and so that's a problem. And two is just, as you may have noticed, I have small eyes. And part of that is because I just have a lot of eyelid, and the problem is that because of how droopy my eyelids are, they actually obscure my vision and also cause more infections. And so I'm probably gonna get a procedure done within the next month or so to see what happens, get it figured out. So that's sort of in my near future. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will catch you guys again tomorrow with another one of these vlogs. Man, I can't believe I'm doing this like every day. Still pretty crazy to me. Anyways, peace.